ripples in a pond. Seismic tremors triggered by an earthquake, light and sound are all wave phenomena.
As a wave propagates, energy is being transferred. Energy carried by light waves from the sun warms the surface of the earth, whereas the energy carried by seismic waves can crack the crust of our planet.
A traveling mechanical wave is a disturbance traveling in a medium. Traveling waves are also called progressive waves or continuous waves. Mechanical waves are waves which propagate only through a material medium, such as a solid, a liquid, or a gas. Let's observe this video. A wave is created in a thick rope by moving head up and down. The medium where the disturbance is traveling in is the rope. Now, look at the circular ripples traveling on the surface of water. The medium where the disturbance is traveling in is the water. By the way, you are listening now to my voice, which is a sound wave traveling to your ears through the air. Air is the medium of propagation of the sound.
In order to have deep understanding of waves, we need first to discuss periodic motion and oscillatory motion. Let's start with periodic motion. Periodic motion is a motion that repeats itself identically during a constant interval of time called the period. The rotation of the Earth around its axis is an example of a periodic motion. It takes the Earth 24 hours to complete one rotation. Then the period of this rotational motion is 24 hours. The motion of the clock pendulum is another example of periodic motion.
Oscillatory motion is a to-and-fro motion of an object about a fixed point, which is the equilibrium position. Now, let's watch some oscillatory motions. When displaced from its equilibrium position, the object attached to the spring moves up and down about this equilibrium position. Now, a man on a swing is moving back and forth about the lowest point. In the last video, a man plays the guitar and chords move up and down about their original position.
In this animation, the block is shifted from its equilibrium position and then it is released from rest. Observe the oscillations. Let's study the properties of oscillatory motion. The first property is the time period, which is the duration of one complete oscillation or cycle. The SI unit of the period is second. Observe. The block is in its lowest position. It takes the block 0.5 seconds to return back to its lowest position for the first time. This time is the period. The second property is the frequency, which is the number of oscillations performed per unit time. The SI unit of the frequency is hertz or cycles per second. Observe. The block completes two oscillations or two cycles in 1 second. Then the frequency is 2 cycles per second or 2 hertz. But 1/T = 1/0.5, which equals 2. Then f = 1/period. The third property is the amplitude, which is the maximum displacement of the oscillating object from its equilibrium position O. The amplitude is a positive quantity, so it is the distance separating the equilibrium position and the highest extreme position or the lowest extreme position.
Focus, please. This is important.
A periodic traveling wave is produced by a source of vibration and propagates in a material medium. What do we mean by periodic traveling wave? If the traveling disturbance repeats itself regularly during a constant interval of time, the wave is called a periodic wave. In this PHET animation, the red and green balls represent the particles of a long rope connected from one of its ends to a source of vibration. When the source does not vibrate, each particle remains at rest in its equilibrium position, as we see in this PHET animation. When the source starts vibrating, a wave is produced and propagates along the rope. The blue line represents the path described by one of the green particles. This particle moves up and down about its equilibrium position and does not travel with the wave. We observe that also each particle oscillates about its equilibrium position and does not travel along the rope. So what do we conclude? We conclude that a vibrating source gives energy which is transported from a particle to another in the medium. Each particle in the medium oscillates about its equilibrium position and does not travel with the wave.
Now let's discuss the properties of a periodic wave. Let's start with the amplitude, which is the maximum displacement relative to the equilibrium level. The amplitude of the wave is equal to that of the source of vibration. Now, I want you to observe the oscillation of this green particle. Let's place a vertical ruler in order to measure the oscillation amplitude of this particle and the amplitude of the wave. The maximum displacement of the particle and of the wave from the equilibrium level is 1 centimeter. Then the amplitude is 1 centimeter. We place the horizontal ruler to show that the amplitude of the periodic wave is constant. Observe.
The second property is the period, which is the time needed by the wave to repeat itself, and it equals to the time needed by each particle to complete one oscillation. The period of the wave is equal to that of the source of vibration. Observe this animation. Consider a wave propagating along a rope. Now, let's start the animation. We notice that in a time of 0.8 seconds, the wave repeats itself. The source of vibration and this particle complete one oscillation. That means the period of this wave is 0.8 seconds.
The third property is the frequency, which is the number of the cycles of the wave per unit time, or the number of oscillations performed by each particle per unit time. The frequency of a wave equals to that of the source of vibration. Then, the source of vibration imposes its frequency to the wave and to each particle in the medium.
The fourth property of the wave is the speed of propagation, which is the distance traveled by the wave per unit time. The speed of most mechanical waves is constant and only depends on the medium in which it travels. Observe this PHET animation. We observe that the wave travels 5 cm in 0.8 seconds. Then the speed of the wave is 5 centimeters over 0.8 seconds, which equals 6.25 centimeters per second.
The fifth property is the wavelength, which is the distance traveled by the wave during one period of the source of vibration, or the distance between two consecutive crests or troughs in a transverse wave. Observe. This wave travels only one wavelength, so the wavelength is 3 centimeters. We can measure the wavelength as the distance between two consecutive crests or two consecutive troughs.